Hi guys, welcome to the first video on this series on the fundamentals of audio editing with PowerDirector. We'll show you the basics of audio editing and how to create great sound in audio. A lot of times, good quality audio is overlooked in video production, often because of a lack of equipment or a well-rounded editing software. You don't want your audio to sound like this
or have wind or noise in the background.
So to start off this series, we're going to give you an introduction on the basics, like how to record audio, how to do your basic audio keyframing, and adjusting the volume of background music when there's dialogue present. For this video, we'll be using PowerDirector for basic audio editing. So if you haven't tried out PowerDirector yet, make sure to download it by clicking on the link here or on the description box below. If you're looking for more advanced audio editing, we'll be giving you pro tips with AudioDirector in part 2 and part 3 of this series. In the meantime, you can also download AudioDirector for free. Find the link in the description below. Let's start off by learning how to record audio or a voiceover in PowerDirector 365. When you're creating a reaction video, tutorial, or even a video ad, being able to record your own audio can be really useful. Open PowerDirector and on the left-hand side menu, click on More, and you'll find a voiceover recording room. Here, there's controls for recording a narration from your selected device while watching a preview of your video production. Once you've set up the profile and recording preferences, just click record. One thing to note is your recording level. Watch the volume meter as you record, as you want to try to stay in the green zone. When volume gets to the yellow and red zones, this means that the volume level is too high and can cause clipping. In PowerDirector, you can either mix audio in track on the timeline or in the audio mixing room. On the timeline, adjust the volume level for the entire duration of a clip by dragging the audio level line up or down. If your audio waveform contains yellow markers on it, this indicates that the audio is clipped or distorted at these points. Or use keyframes to mix an individual clip's audio in the timeline. Hold down the Control key on your keyboard and click on the audio level line at the point where you want to change the audio level. Drag the volume keyframe up to increase the volume or down to decrease the volume. For more precise audio adjustments, we can also move into the audio mixing room. To set the audio level for each track, you have these controls available. Increase or decrease the volume by selecting a clip on the timeline and use the master volume controls. Also, it's important to crossfade your audio between clips. Fade audio in and out to avoid audio sounding disjointed to create a smooth transition between two tracks with no sudden stops or moments of silence. A quick and easy way to set similar level volume for all audio on the same track is to normalize. This enables you to make the volume or gain of all the audio on a single track around the same level without constantly making adjustments. What if you've got both background music and narration going on at the same time? Audio ducking is a powerful feature in PowerDirector that can automatically optimize the audio mix in videos that contain dialogue or narration by fitting background music tracks so that speech can be clearly heard. Select a video or audio clip on the timeline that you want to have a lower volume. Click Tools above the timeline and select Audio Ducking. And here are some controls you can customize. Sensitivity sets the level of detection of dialogue narration in other clips. The ducking level is how much you want to reduce the volume in the selected clip. And the fade in and out duration sets the duration for fading the audio out or back in once the dialogue or narration ends. Another great tool for editing background music in PowerDirector is the Audio Smart Fit feature. Say you've got a video clip and you want to add some background music, but the music clip is way too long. With Audio Smart Fit, you can automatically tailor background music to fit the length of your footage. It automatically analyzes any song to make it shorter or longer, so you don't have to manually adjust the length. Either fit to the project or your playhead position or set a custom duration. That's it for the basic of audio editing in PowerDirector. Stay tuned for the next video in this series where we'll cover how to fine-tune your audio to produce crisper, clearer sound. Don't miss out on the video by subscribing to our channel. See you next time.